Jackson is the hometown boy from Tishomingo, Oklahoma, and is a health and wellness major. This evening, he's escorted by his mom, Jessica Lally, and his father, Brad Lally. His favorite memory at Murray State College was staying in hotels with the team. He plans to continue his athletic and academic career at a university. As you can, that's number three, Jackson Lally. Last and certainly not least, ladies and gentlemen, Trayvon Williams. Trey is from Denver, Colorado, is an arts and science major. He is escorted by his mom, Mary. His favorite memory at Murray State College was riding the jet ski and hanging out at the lake house. Trayvon plans to play basketball at the highest level, be a great father, and have a healthy family. Ladies and gentlemen, give a big round of applause. That's number 13, Trayvon Williams. And let's take this opportunity, Aggie fans, your 2024 Murray State College men's basketball sophomores. This concludes our 2024 sophomore recognition. Thank you for your attendance. Please give a round to the general family in Western Oklahoma State College. Tip off will be in just a little bit. Meantime, we have a concession stand located in the southwest portion of the building, restrooms in the western part of the building. We'll have some basketball here in just a little bit. See you soon.
hope you're having a wonderful time while we play some great music on game time. Welcome to Murray State College. All fans should realize that by their attendance at this game, they become participants. And the schools will soon be responsible for all participants. More music to come here on game time. Thank you.
Thank you. Is it time?
It's time for some NJCAA Division I basketball. Featuring the Mary State College Aggies on the BGC Sports Network and the BGC Sports Network 2. Here's your play-by-play announcer, Cedric Bailey.
All right, about ready. I'm going to turn it over to our announcer, Derek Crawford. He's going to introduce our starting lineup, and I'll tell you who they are as they come on the court. We had Jack Hoth. He's a sophomore, 6'4", from St. Paul, Minnesota. Number 5, Yanis Mahato, guard, freshman from France. Number 11, Jane Hoth from St. Paul, Minnesota. Number 14, Dina Muhammad, St. Paul, Minnesota. Number 22, Dang Akoff, 6'8", freshman from Manchester, New Hampshire. Starting lineup for Western Oklahoma State Pioneers. Here comes your Murray State Aggies. And a big surprise tonight, starting all the sophomores. All the people standing up there, they have them from Tishomingo for the hometown. Jackson Lawley. From Waldorf, Maryland, Stanley Harley in the house. Mr. Murray himself, Terrence Alston. Trayvon Williams, number 13. Number 33, Emery Everhart. Thank you to all the fans who made it in tonight from everywhere. Should be an interesting matchup. Right now, the Aggies are third in the Region 2. And the worst they could do is get the four spot. We already know that NEO and Connors have top live, you know, there's a battle for the top spot. I think NEO has lost two games. The last time we played against NEO, the game almost went in overtime, and we lost 87-85. So here we go, Everhart jumping for the Aggies, and of course, Pioneers win the tip. Rugging it around during this time period. Harley will be in on the defense on him. Good reach in there by Murray State. Almost got it. 10 seconds on the shot clock. And they shoot it from the three, and they missed. Rebound, Trayvon Williams for the Aggies. Here they come with the first possession here in the first period. Harley's going to handle the ball. Directed traffic. Jackson Lawley working around. Austin gets it back to Lawley. He's going to shoot the three, and he broke it! My man, Jackson Lawley, opened the game for the Aggies. Felt that one. He told me one time, he said, I do at least 200 or 300 three-pointers on a daily basis. So he sees it in his mind that that's what he's going to do. Pioneers. With the shot off the glass, rebound, Trayvon Williams. Harley with a pass to Trayvon, bounce to Everhart. And he shoots that left-handed, and he felt that one. Nice job, Emery Everhart. 5-0 in favor of Murray State. Austin with the defense on him. He shoots, misses, fight for the rebound. Trayvon, it hits off his head. He throws it down court to Terrence Austin. Not enough Aggies back there. Here comes. It's going to be a foul. They're going to call it on the floor. No basket. Foul is going to be called against Trayvon Williams. That's his first foul. No shooting foul. Aggies lead 5-0 here with 18-15. That's a turnover. Emory Eberhardt right there to get the ball at the right spot. Lolly dribbles it up. Harley goes up on the rim. He takes it. Misses it, but he had the right idea. Not afraid to go in there. Three-pointers underway, and it's going to be missed. Rebound. Superman Trayvon Williams. Nice job attacking the rim. Harley with the ball gets it out to Jackson Lolly in the corner. A lot of ball movement for the Aggies. Terrence Austin with it. A bounce pass, and that's a turnover. He's got to get back 2-on-1. Alley out, and it's up, and it's good. That's scored by number 5, Giannis Mahondo, after getting the assist from Jack Hawk. So the Pioneers are on the board with 2 points. And that pass is good. Trayvon Williams with the three-pointer. He's on the board. Shot is up, and it's a miss. He tried to think about putting it up, and he does, but he misses. Ball hits the floor as, of course, Muhammad was the one who put the ball up. Aggies lead 7-2. There goes Harley kicking it to the corner. Terrence Austin! And we got a timeout on the court. Our score, Aggies 10, Pioneers 2. We'll be right back here on the Murray State Aggie YouTube channel. All right, coming out of the media timeout, it's going to be the Pioneers ball. They bring it across. Setting up their offense. Still on the court. Starters for the Aggies. Coach Davis not going to make any changes. These guys are doing pretty good, so keep the chemistry going. 3-pointers on the way, and that's going to be short. Fight for the rebound. Eberhardt tries to get it, but the Pioneers do pull it down. Working it around. 3-pointers underway, and it's going to be short. Fight for the rebound. And the Pioneers do come up with it. That is scored by Dave Dales. He is a sophomore, 6'4", from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Shout-outs to the Pioneer fans that are with us tonight, and so as well as the Aggies. 3-pointer! Jackson Lolly is taking it to the First United Bank on tonight. Didn't even have to hit it off the glass. And that's his second three-pointer on tonight. So he's got 6 tonight for Murray State. They're going to call a foul. I believe that's going to be on Jackson Lolly. We're waiting on the official to come over. He does. He calls it on Jackson. Blocking foul. So we got, let's give these guys a big hand as they come on out right now. Now in the game for Murray State is going to be Iggy, number 20. Okay, also number 1, Isaiah Lewis. Rustin Coffey is in the game now as well. So one thing I can tell you about what Coach Davis does is he goes to a rotation, and he goes in there and he goes back and forth.
Thank you.
All right, coming out of the media timeout, it is going to be the Pioneers ball. They get it inbound, so they've got a new lineup on the court. Lewis, Iggy, Trayvon Williams, R.J. Chapman, and Terrence Austin. That's our starters that are normally out there, except for Trayvon. Shot is up. Usually if Rustin Coffee is in. That basket is good, scored by Jack Haas. Now I'm going to tell you what happened. This team, when we played them back on the road out in Altus, they beat us. But we've been playing pretty good at home. Trayvon Williams shoots a three-pointer. He misses. Rebound, Pioneers. They get the ball up the court. Here they come. Williams tried to come in there and slow him down. They're going to shoot an NBA three-pointer, and that's an air ball. And that's going to hit the wall. Turnover on the Pioneers is going to be the Aggies ball. R.J. Chapman bringing the ball in now for between him and Lewis working it back and forth. Terrence Austin with a three-pointer, and he got it. He's still shooting from the First United Bank. Keep shooting, Terrence. He's got five for the Aggies. 16-6, Murray State leading. Shout out to all the families that made it in down here to Tishomingo. And he shoots. That basket is going to be missed. Rebound. Iggy's got it for Murray State. Here comes Lewis. Isaiah Lewis bringing the ball down the court for Murray State. He finds Austin. Austin's trying to figure out who he's going to get it to, and he does. Bounce pass. Should be kick ball. No, 3 seconds called against Iggy. Iggy is from London, by the way. Pioneers with the ball at the top of the key, working it around. And that ball's going to be, oh, they're going to call holding foul against R.J. Chapman for the Aggies. That's his first foul. Harley's going to come back in the game. And he's back in the game now. He's going to come in for Terrence Austin. That shot is going to be an air ball. Pioneers with it, and he's in the middle, and he shoots, and it should be a foul call. It's just a matter of which Aggie he's going to call it on. Waiting on the call from the official. He comes over to the table, and he's going to call that on. That's going to be on Iggy. That's his first foul. At the line, shooting. And that basket is good. Now Rustin Coffey is going to come in the game for Trayvon Williams. And he hits the first one and misses the second. Haas with two free throws, one for one. Aggies lead 16-7. 13:35 here in the first period. Coffey get the pass from Iggy. He kicks it out to Chapman. Chapman gets it over to Rustin. Coffey with a three. We'll take it. We're doing pretty good from the free throw line tonight, three-point line. I've got at least 5 3-pointers for the Aggies on tonight. Shot is up. It's missed. And that's going to be Aggies ball. Left in the first period, first half. Aggies, double-digit lead, holding on to it. Got to be careful with this team. Shot is up by Harley. He shoots, misses, fight for the rebound. Lewis is going to be right there, trying to slow him down. Western Pioneers working around. Shot is up and he misses. Rebound, fight for it. Pioneers come out with the ball. Shot is up. It is an air ball as it hits the wall. Aggies doing a pretty good job on the defense of tonight. Aggies bring the ball in. 12-16. Lewis with the ball. He's thinking about the shot. He does shoot it. And he draws the foul, so he's going to get three free throws. So he's going to shoot three free throws. First shot is on the way. Going to let him go ahead and do that. Lewis hits all three free throws, makes it 22-7, the score. Pioneers try to get it up, and they do shoot. It's off the glass. The basket is scored by Ding Akok. He's from New Hampshire, Manchester, New Hampshire. Terrence Austin. 3-pointer, that's his second one. Aggies have hit 6 3-pointers on tonight, looking pretty good. Shot is up, forced, it's missed. Coffee comes up with the rebound, gets it to Lewis, and he's going to go. And he draws, good shot, Isaiah Lewis. Aggies are looking real good on tonight, shooting at least over 55%. I'm just guessing. Shot is on the way, and is that an offensive foul? It is. Guess who took that charge, folks? Terrence Austin did. That's called against Chang Hoth. Hoth, that's his first foul. So we got a media timeout. We'll be right back. Keep it right here on the Aggies YouTube channel. 27-9 is the score with 11:04 left in the first half. Aggies working the ball around. Terrence Austin. Lolly back on the court. Lewis is on the court. So is Devontae Campbell and Rusty Coffee. Three-pointers underway. Miss. Campbell almost deflects it off the rim. Day, will he is a rim protector too as well. And they're going to call a foul against the Aggies. And they're going to call that foul against Murray State. It's going to be called against Rustin Coffee. And in the game, in for Coffee, is going to be number 13, Trayvon Williams. Looking at the team fouls, Murray State has 5 compared to Western with 2. Ball is inbound. Shot is up. Good job by Murray. Comes up there. Day Campbell comes up with the rebound. Lolly with the ball. He goes to go in and kicks it back out. Trayvon Williams shoots. Rebound. Pioneers. Three-pointers on the way, and it's in and out. Rebound. Day Campbell gets it off. He's got Lewis up under the rim, a little bit too far under. He couldn't recover like he wanted to. Austin thought about it. He takes it in. Oh, my God. Did you see that? Did you see that? That's ESPN, baby. Nice move, Terrence Austin. Don't know what he did, but he went behind his back legs or something. But it was a nice move. And he put it off with his left hand. Shot is underway. Miss. That's a late foul call. And they're going to call it on Day Campbell. I do want to say I think that's a late call. So that's going to send number 20, Terrence T.J. Newton, to the line. He's from Berkmanette, Texas. That's near Wichita Falls. He's got 2 free throws coming. First one is up, and it's missed. And the second shot is good. Newton is on the board for the Pioneers. Lewis with a pass. Trying to get it to Devontae Day Campbell, and he missed it. Oh, Superman! Did you see that? He came out of nowhere. The cape came on, and he blocked it. And, oh, double block. Man, the action is going on here at and Tishomingo at Murray State. Shot is up and it's good. Dave Dales from Fort Lauderdale made that basket. 29-12 Aggies lead. Campbell, it was thrown at his feet. He couldn't pull it down and get it up. And they're going to call the foul against the Pioneers. They're going to charge that to number 20. Terrence Newton, that's his first foul. Pass is in. Trayvon is fouled. Nice pass by Lewis. And that's back-to-back fouls called against. Back-to-back fouls called against. I got him for 2. Okay. Did he make both? Okay, thank you. A lot of stuff going on here at the bench, y'all, so excuse me. We want to make sure we get it right. Aggies lead 31-12 in the first half. Now for, of course, Western is going to be number 23. That is... I'm trying to see who he is. Okay, I got the player now that's in there for the Pioneers. Number 23 is D. Davis is what we have listed. They have a lot of players. They do have one player from Oklahoma on there. They got a lot of international players from France and Spain and Portland, Maine. Got one player from Dallas, so they have a very diverse team for Western. 31-14, Aggies holding on to that 31-14 lead, 7:42. Williams on the court, Austin Iggy's on the court, Stanley Harley and Isaiah Lewis. Three-pointers up and it's good. Count the basket, that is number two, Dave Daigle. He scored again, he scored the last two baskets. Way over in the corner, Harley pulls it down. Working it quick, Terrence Austin. Trying to get the three-pointer. And Austin goes for the ball. There goes Trayvon fighting for it. And that's going to be called out on Austin. He was on the line. Got a lot of bodies flying on the floor, folks. That's all I can tell you. A lot of action on the floor. And they got a wet spot on the floor. All right, they got the spot. Here goes back to the action. Working it around. Shot is up and it's missed. Pioneers get the ball back. Drive in. And that should have been a foul. He's all on his back, but they didn't call it. Dave Dahl has scored the last 6 points for Western and scored 10 points in the game. Kicked off in the corner, Harley, nice move, shot is up. Missed, a little long. Lewis with the defense on it, he missed the shot. There goes Harley with the ball, kicks it off to Austin. Austin's gonna go for it. Oh, he puts it up, left-handed with a floater, again! You're talking about using your body. Terrence Austin knows how to work around that rim. Got him for 12 points on tonight, folks. There's a steal. Lewis, he's going to dunk it. Oh! And somehow he gets it back. And they're going to call a foul on number 21 for Western. Lamarion McFarland, he's from Reading, Pennsylvania. Now coming back in the game, it's going to be number 20, Iggy. He's going to come in for Emory Everhart. Aggie's going to inbound the ball. Austin gets it. They're all over him. And he's going to drop a floater up. A little short, fight for the rebound. Iggy tried to get in there but couldn't pull it down, so here comes Western. Taking it in the hole, and it's gonna be a turnover, no call. Austin, Harley off the glass, left-handed. You run with Murray, they're gonna run right with you. So if you wanna run, let's run. Harley with the ball, and it's going to come right in front of us, and Western is going to recover to pick it up. Hey, 3-point is underway. It's missed. Fight for the rebound. Stanley Harley, he's everywhere. Hammond Lewis. 4:30 left here in the first half. Aggies lead 35-19. In the corner, Stanley. It's going to bounce. It goes off of Terrence Austin. R.J. Chapman checking back in the game. Comes in for Terrence Austin. This shot is underway and it's good. Count the basket. That's number one for Western. He hits a three-pointer, so 35-22. Harley takes it in, and it's going to be a turn. Wait a minute. They got to call jump ball. Media timeout. Media timeout. We'll take that timeout. We'll be right back. So keep it right here on the Aggies YouTube channel. All right, coming out the media timeout. That goes off of Iggy, and Coffee is there to get the ball. Bounce pass, shot is up. Lewis shoots it. There's a foul on the floor. And it's going against Western. It's going to be called against Dave Dahl. First foul, 16 foul. Isaiah Lewis at the line, two shots. And he connects. That's his fourth free throw tonight. He's got one more. That'll give him five. He connects on this. He had a phenomenal game on his last one here against NEO. And he connects. Last time the team played, they were on the road. They went to Wilmington and lost that game by 10 points to the Mountaineers. Weston taking the ball in straight to the hole. Shot is off the glass. Missed. Fight for the rebound. And here comes the Aggies. R.J. Chapman with it. There's Lewis with an alley-oop to Terrence. Trayvon Williams. Coffey with the shot. Off the glass. Count it for Murray State. What a goal, Rustin, for staying in there and not giving up. 3:13 left, folks. And that's blocked partially by the Aggies. That's Iggy. His real name is Ignis Jisviscus, but we call him Iggy. Just want to make that clarity for our fans in Barking London. 39-22, Aggies been leading the whole game. They started off with a five-point lead. And that's a turnover. The ball is thrown up in the stands. .304. Pass back to Trayvon. He gets the ball after some type of miss. Chapman with a three-pointer, It's good. It rattled in. We'll take it. R.J. Chapman, the 5'8 point guard, freshman from Saxey, Texas. Shot is up by Western. It's missed. Rebound. Pioneers. Rustin Coffee. Is that jump ball? That's what it is. Good job. Good defense. Rustin Coffee from Valiant, Oklahoma, the freshman. Day Campbell is going back in the game for Murray State. Bounce pass in. And that's Lewis comes up with the steal for the Aggies. Here he goes. Isaiah Lewis. Chapman gets the ball. Bounce pass. Lewis from Chapman. A little long. Rebound. Western. Working it around. Dribbling in the paint off the glass, and it's high. Missed. Trayvon Williams. And he's going to call a jump ball. And the arrow's in favor of Murray State. Going to be checking to the chat room here and see who's on board watching on YouTube. So if you're watching, send us a shout out so we can send you a shout out. Aggie shoot. Good job. Coffee comes in off, gets it to Chapman with a floater. Misses, but Williams is there. And somehow he gets the ball. Coffee loses it. Oh, he tried to do a two-hand slam. He missed it. Oh, my God. That's a young man from France. Yanis Mahondo. Tried to do a two-hand slam, and he just missed it. He's looking at his hand like, what happened? I'll tell you what happened. You just misjudged it. Trayvon Williams with the ball. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Got to get it up. Get it up. It's short. It's going to be about like shot clock violation. When they tap that head, that's what it is. Harley and, of course, Austin coming in for Coffee and R.J. Chapman. 1 minute and 1 second. We're going to the chat room to see who's on board tonight with the Aggie fans. Christina Avila, Harold Smith. What's up, Harold? You back in here? And Chris Austin, I see you. Rosie Chapman, one of our faithful. She's always on board. Thank you, Aggie Nation. Spin, shots up off the glass, count the basket, scored by Dina Muhammad from St. Paul, Minnesota. 40 seconds left. Aggies lead 42-24, trying to get it's an 18-point lead right now. Austin takes it in, and he's blocked. Fight for it. Campbell gets it. He gets it out to Harley. Harley's going to take it into the hole, and he's going to shoot and draw the foul. And they call the foul against Damari Davis, that's his first foul. Harley's going to go to the line to shoot free throws. Harley shoots, and it's short. By the way, I want to say hello to the family of Terrence Austin. They brought a lot of people down from Colorado here. Met a lot of the players' family, so shout outs to all of you, and thank you for the kind words on what you say about us here at Murray State. We appreciate you. Can't wait till graduation time. That basket is good by Harley, so he connects on the second free throw. I got him going to the free throw line twice tonight. One for one. 43-24, Aggies lead by 18, and that's going to be, no, 19, and that's going to be a foul called against Stanley Harley. That should be his first foul. 1-1, 43-24 is our score. Aggies maintaining that 19-point lead. Emory Everhart about to check back in. He's going to come in for Dave Campbell. And timeout, Murray. They'll take the timeout. We'll be right back as he connects on that free throw. All right, coming out of that timeout, that was charged to Murray State. Coach Davis called it. Shout out to, of course, media director, Justin Wagner, Jeremy Wagner, Bob Davis, all up under the staff of Coach Josh Davis here at Murray State. Both those free throws are hit. Harley with the ball, 14 seconds. And that's going to be a turnover on the Aggies to be Pioneers ball. 10.2 seconds left. 43-26. Day Campbell trying to check back in the game right now. He comes back in for Emory Everhart. Ten seconds, and they got the ball. Floater, it's missed. Rebound. Williams, 1 second, they get it back, the shot is up, and it's no good. All right, at the half, our score, Aggies 43 and Pioneers 26. We'll be right back in 10 minutes here on the Murray State Aggie YouTube channel. Stay with us.
Know someone with a drug or alcohol problem? Get help right now. Insurance may cover everything. Stop the drug and alcohol nightmare. Are drug and alcohol problems hitting you too close to home? Get help right now. Insurance may cover everything.
800-694-1127. 800-694-1127. That's 800-694-1127.
No.
All right, folks, here we go. Coming out the second half. 43-26. Time for the second half. Pioneers with the ball to start. Shot is up. Miss, rebound, Murray. Starters back on the court. Harley, number 4. Everhart, number 33. Terrence Austin, number 5. Trayvon Williams, number 13. And Jackson Lawley, number 3. And that shot is going to be a dunk scored by Dave Dahl. We have to stop if we got a player that's down for Western. We're going to stop right quick and let him check on him. Injured player is number 11, Chang Holt. Number 1 and number 11 are brothers, by the way. They look like they're identical twins. Austin with the ball in the corner. Nice pass, Trayvon Williams, he gets it off to Stanley Harley, who comes in the paint and scores. 45-28. That's the air ball. Harley out on the court now. Jackson Lawley with a three-pointer. It's in and out, comes out. Harley back on defense for the Aggies. Hoff takes the ball and scores. That was number 1, Jack Hoff, that scored. Trayvon had to pull it back, takes it in, scores. Off, oh, good job, he had it. But good job of Emory Everhart was right there to get the ball and draws the foul. Dini Muhammad is the one that was charged with the foul. That's his first team foul. At the line shooting two free, well, it's not going to be free throws. The ball's going to be inbound up under the rim. Trayvon Williams with the ball. Shot, miss. Terrence Austin, he looked and said, oh my God. Couldn't believe he did that. It happens sometimes. He says, my bad, and keeps it moving. Aggies lead by 15, 45-30. Hoth with a three-pointer. It's in and out. He missed it. Thought he had the shot. Aggies with the rebound. In the corner, Stanley Harley. That's a three-pointer. Nice job for Stanley. Family loved that shot. Had a chance to talk to his family here earlier tonight. Good job by Trayvon. Forces the ball to go off of Parents did not like that call. They reversed it because another official came over and said, no, I saw it had a better angle. Well, Coastal came out of his jacket. Coach Davis asking for a recall. We don't get that in this level. Wow. Basket is good by Dave Dow. He's their leading scorer on tonight. I got him down for at least 14 points. He's got half of their offense. Three-pointers underway. It's going to be missed. Fight for the ball. Austin is right there on the defense on him, on Dave Dow. And that's going to be a foul called against Murray State. They're going to call that on Stanley Harley. That's his second team foul. Now back in the game is Isaiah Lewis in for Jackson Lawley. Back in the game for Western is number 11, Chang Ha. And that bad shoot is good, Jack Ha. Harley thinks about going in, he steps back. Emory Eberhardt takes it in and draws the foul. It's going to be called against number two. And it's going to be charged against Dave Dahl. That's his second. Team foul number two here in the second half. Foul was on the floor, so the Aggies going to inbound the ball. And he gets it in to Isaiah Lewis. Harley steps in. He goes in. Passes off to Trayvon, and he shoots it. It's off the glass. Left-handed shot is up, and Trayvon finds the ball, gets it back in there. And that's a turnover. Shot is on the way, and it's good. Basket is scored by Dang Aka. 4 points for him in this game. Aggies lead is only 12 points, 48-36. 15-31 left in the ball game. Harley takes it in. He passes off to Eberhardt. He spins. Austin is there. He's going to go in there, shoots off the glass, and he misses. Rebound. Oh, man. That should have been a technical foul. He hooked him. Dean Muhammad, the 6'8 sophomore forward. We got a media timeout. We'll be right back after this, so keep it right here on the Murray State Aggie YouTube channel. All right, back to the action after that media timeout. Let's see who's on the court for Murray State. Looks like number zero, R.J. Chapman's out there. Eberhardt, Trayvon Williams, Terrence Austin, and Isaiah Lewis on the court for Murray State. Isaiah Lewis in the corner with a three-pointer, and he was ready. Catch and shoot. Nice basket. He was ready for that one. Shot is up. It's missed. Rebound. It's a save. And that is going to be Western's ball. Trayvon tried to throw it back in. They do get the ball in. Running their offense, Western does. Pioneers kicks it out. Shot is on the way, and it's going to be a good. That basket scored. Deanie Muhammad. So that's his three-pointer. 51-39. Western trying to hang in there. Can't take a chance. Trayvon finds Emory Eberhardt. That should have been basket interference, and that's goaltending. Good shot, Emory. That's his fourth point on tonight. good fan base here on tonight, here on sophomore night. I want to say hello to the president, Dr. Tim Fulton. He's here on tonight. They were here. I see the Aggies tip-off club and got a good group here tonight to support the Aggies in their final game at home. And that ball's going to bounce right in front of the scores table. Aggies ball. Again, Aggies, they're in the tournament. That'll be on Wednesday. We'll find out the seedings and let you know. Be sure to check out my show, Sports in the Mix, on the BGC Sports Network. And we'll let you know. I'll have that available for you. Austin with the ball, getting a nice pass. He shoots up, and he scores. Don't know how he did it, but he did it, folks. Showing out on his final game here at home. Played both years for Coach Davis. It's good to see his family that made it in tonight to support him and to all the players and their families. Aggies lead 55-39. Working the ball around, trying to get it in. Three-point is underway, and it's good. That is Changhoff. That's his first three-pointer on tonight. Williams backdoored R.J. Chapman. He pulls it back. Austin's going to shoot. It's an air ball. Rebound. Pioneers, 2-on-1. And that is a dunk, but it's in and out. Oh, R.J. Chapman, did you see that, folks? He blocks Hoth. Shot is up. Good follow-up. We had two good looks at it, couldn't get it in. When they want to run, they want to run. Three-pointers underway. It's Smith, fight for the ball. Emory Everhart with the ball, comes down. And here's Austin. There he goes. And that's a turnover. Pioneers was not having it. Now that's a foul that's going to be called against Trayvon Williams. Boy, they are running fast on tonight. That foul is going to be uncalled on Trayvon Williams. I have his second foul. Back in the game, Rustin Coffee and Stanley Harley in for the Aggies. So, second foul on Trayvon Williams, second team foul. 12:36 left in this ball game. Aggies lead by 13. 55-42. Oh, and there's Isaiah Lewis right there to intercept that pass. Kicks it off to the teammate. That's Stanley Harley there. Trayvon Williams is going to shoot it, and he counts the basket. Good. Trayvon Williams got 5. Make it 7 points for him. He's got 2 free throws. Pretty balanced attack tonight for Coach Josh Davis, Murray State Aggies basketball team. This is March Madness, folks. And he throws the ball and it hits the feet of Stanley Harley. So we got a media timeout. We need to take a break anyway. We'll be right back here on the Murray State Aggie YouTube channel. All right, back to the action coming out of this timeout, media timeout. Pioneers going to inbound the ball. They do. 11:55. That's turnover. There goes Trayvon Williams. Nice pass to R.J. Chapman. A floater. Oh, my goodness. Isaiah Lewis came out of nowhere and got that and put it back up. Man, that was a nice alley-oop. Layup and count the basket. Lewis. Shot is up, and that's going to be a foul. Should be called against the Pioneers. It is. They're going to call that on Dang Akar. They said he was on his back. Time out. Western. We'll be right back. 59-42. Don't go nowhere. Aggies are staying strong. All right, coming out of that timeout, that was charged to the Pioneers. Be sure to check out our page on tomorrow and get the results. Find out who's going to be playing in Muskogee. The tournament is going to be Wednesday, March 13th, 14th, and the championship on the 15th. Looking forward to seeing you there. Oh, nice pass. Dunk by Rustin Coffey from Valiant, Oklahoma. Wide open. Great job by the Aggies executing that. A lot of ball move. Can't wait to talk to Coach Davis at the end of this day. Harley on the defense. Everybody's got out there as a scrapper. It seems like when we play at home, we just get all this energy. So that's going to be a holding foul, and it's going to be called against Murray State. They're going to call that on Stanley Harley. That's his third team foul. Third team foul, his third personal foul. Ball is inbound, shot is up, and it's a miss. Fight for the rebound. Aggies come up with the ball. Lewis takes his time, works it around. R.J. Chapman in the corner. And he's going to lose the ball. Coffey tries to come up with it. He's not able to do anything. He bounces up and gets down the court. Here comes the Pioneers. Euro step. And it's a floater, and it's good. That looks like that was Ding Dahl who scores that, and he's their leading scorer on tonight. Shot is up. It's missed. Williams fights for the ball. Everybody's on the floor. Get up. Jack Haas with the ball. He's going to be fouled by Isaiah Lewis. No, they call it on Trayvon Williams. That's his third foul. He's going to come out and have a seat. Terrence Austin is going to come relieve him. Coach is giving him high five for his efforts and what he's done in this game. Ball is inbound. And Terrence Austin. He knows how to get up under your skin. Almost tied him up. But the ball went off of the Aggies, so it's going to be the Pioneers' ball. 10:04. Aggies lead by 15. And offensive foul. Terrence Austin set him up like he was at the grocery store. And that foul is going to be on Dino Muhammad. That's his third foul. Terrence knows how to use his body well. One thing that the parents told me tonight is that they could say that he's always had a knack for getting in the middle. As small as he is, he knows how to get in the paint. We have him listed as 5'9". But he plays like he's 6 feet. Okay, they cleaned the floor. Got the wet spot up. Austin gets the ball. I'm sorry. Chapman gets the ball in. And he takes it into the hole. Stanley Harley from Waldorf, Maryland. Now, I got to ask him a question about this, because if y'all didn't see this earlier, as he draws the foul on 14 on Muhammad, so Muhammad's going to have to come sit down. Harley's going to go to the free throw line and shoot a free throw. So back in the game, it'll be Chubaya from Portland, Maine. Now, Harley had a headband on earlier in the game, and he took it off. He's going to shoot this three play if he can make it, free throw. It's a 20-point game, 64-44. This team knows how to turn it up. I can't wait to go see them playing in Muskogee, folks. We're going to be there. Shot is up. Missed. That was shot by number 11, Ching Haas, and that's a turnover on the Pioneers Aggies ball. So remember now, you got to be able to go to the NJCAA website, Region 2. They'll be in Muskogee at the Ruffers Stadium. Long shot over, way off by Terrence Austin. Three-pointer's underway, and it's missed. Fight for the rebound. And that's stolen by Isaiah Lewis. Good job on the defense. Harley in the corner. He's going to drive his way in. He shoots. Misses. Fight for the rebound. And it's going to be the Pioneers ball. 9 minutes left in this ball game. 20-point lead for the Aggies. 64-44. Dave Campbell is about to check back in for the Aggies. Pioneers with the ball, top of the key, getting into the corner. Shot is on the way. It's a miss. Rebound, R.J. Chapman for the Aggies. Chapman with the ball. He gets it to Lewis. Lewis finds Harley. Tries to throw a pass and couldn't get the timing down. Got to be careful with the ball. He said, that's my fault. So Dave Campbell is going to come back in the game. He's going to come in and let's see. Coffee is out. Williams is back in the game and Dave Campbell. We got Lewis, Chapman, and Austin on the floor. Final game of the regular season at home. It's been a winning season for both Aggie teams, women and the men's team. And as he's on the line, it's a turnover. Aggies ball, good defense. One more, he'll be going to the free throw line. That's six fouls called against the Pioneers and four against Murray State. Bounce pass to Austin. Dave Campbell right there and gets the basket counted, Murray State. Nice pass, nice shot. And we're going to have official timeout. We'll be right back. 66-44. 7:45 left in this game. We'll be right back. Don't get alone, let me try it. What's the point of even trying? I ain't a goofy expression. They always All right, coming out of that timeout, official timeout, they get the ball in. Pioneers do. Aggies have been holding on to that lead, the biggest of the night, 22-point lead. Fight for the rebound. Williams comes up with the ball. He gets it to Day Campbell. Campbell, R.J. Chapman with a shot. He misses. Rebound. Pioneers. Aggies have led throughout the entire game. They led at half 43-26. Get it down low. Kicks it out to the corner. Three-pointers underway, and it's good. Basket is scored by number 20, Terrence T.J. Newton. Three-pointer. How about it? R.J. Chapman answers. .69-47, 22-point lead again. 6:34. Aggies playing great defense. Closest they were able to get it to was 12 points, but the Aggies turned on the pressure. Shot is up, and that's going to be a foul. Foul is going to be called against Day Campbell. That's his second team foul. Count the basket. And he misses. That's Chell back. He scores his first 2 points, and he shoots a free throw and misses it. Oh, Day Campbell in there. Oh, look at there. No worries. Trayvon said, I got you, bro. He was right there. That's 9 points for him. Coach Davis said, what a way to be wake. Trayvon being right there. That's what makes him so great is because their effort and their hustle to the rim. In the middle, shot is up, and it's good. That basket is scored again by Chuo Bayard. He's a 6'9". Sophomore from Portland, Maine. Both of these teams will be heading to the tournament in Muskogee. R.J. Chapman again with another Bank United. That is First United Spin Life Wisely three-pointer. Wasn't off the bank rim. It was just straight in. So he's got 3 three-pointers tonight, R.J. Chapman. Shot is up, it's missed, rebound, Lewis. There he goes with a bounce pass to Chapman. He's gonna shoot for the fourth one, and he misses. Coach is gonna rest the guys out on the court, and that shot is good. It's scored by Dang a Coke. Chapman gets the ball across the line. Trayvon behind the pack, pass to Day Campbell, and it's not going to be able to control it. Chapman's got to get back. And it's going to be the Aggies ball. So we got substitution in the game. Everhart, Harley, and Jackson Lawley in the game. Coming in for Day Campbell. Terrence Austin. No, he's going to stay in. It's going to be Lewis and R.J. Chapman. So we got a timeout on the court. They're going to talk a little quick. Nope, no timeout. They just entering new players in again. So Lawley and Harley are going to be impounding the ball. Lawley is 3 and Harley's 4. Four minutes and 32 seconds left in this ball game. It's been a heck of a season so far for the Murray State Aggies. And thank you for all you fans that are watching us on tonight. Harley with the ball. He drives. Bounce pass to Trayvon. Shot is partially blocked. And looks like number 12 is going to be fouled. And it's going to be called. That foul was charged to number 13, Trayvon Williams. I should have him for his fourth foul in the game. So that's going to send Bayek at the line. I have Trayvon for four. Shot is up and he misses it. It was a one-on-one. Williams with the ball, bounce packs back. Jackson Lawley, he shoots, and he hits it. Lawley, he had a two-pointer that time, so I have him down for 8 points in the game. Here on sophomore night. Harley with the rebound. 3:41. Lawley with the alley-oop pass. Wasn't able to get it down. Here comes the Pioneers. And the basket is good. Scored by Changhoff. And that's a good bounce by Stanley Harley. Terrence Austin. Got him for 16 points on tonight. Euro step on that one and up for the shot and he misses. That was Dale Day. Everhart with the rebound. Harley takes it in the trees, shoots it off the glass, and draws the foul. Stanley Harley. Nice move by Harley. Timeout, 80-55 on tonight. Both teams have led throughout the game and not have not given up. And they have led 80-55. We'll take a break. We'll be right back here on the Murray State Aggie YouTube channel. All right, welcome back, fans. Just send a thank you to all of you that are watching us tonight. The Aggies going to get their win on this evening. And I want to say a special thank you to our IT tech. His name is Sean Dean. He's the one that sets it up where we can be able to broadcast on our Murray YouTube channel. So thank you, Sean, for all that you do. Harley's going to go at the line and shoot and try to complete that free throw. And he does, and he connects. Aggies on D. Oh, good job, Stanley Harley. He picked him. Nice pass to Lawley, but he wasn't able to get it there to him because the Pioneers are there to be on the defense. Shot is up and it's good. Count the basket. Dave Dale. He has been their leading scorer on tonight. Lawley with the ball. Bounce pass to Trayvon. Kicks it out to Stanley Harley. He's going to shoot a three. And he took that to the First United Bank. 84-58. Murray State. 153 and counting. Kicks it off in the corner. Shot is on the way. Bounce pass. And Aggies come up with a steal. There's Austin with the ball. As they were able to pick the ball from Dean Muhammad. Pass low down Emmy Everhart. He spins and he loses the ball. And that ball is too far. Turnover Western. Coach Davis is telling everybody to give his team plan. Given he's taking out his sophomores tonight, Jackson Lawley getting a hand. Now he's going to pull out Terrence Austin. Give him a big hand. Harley's going to give him a big hand. And Trayvon tonight wanted to make sure he shows some respect for his players on tonight. So y'all make sure that you share your comments, what you enjoyed about this team, and let them know how much you appreciate them. Now, like I said earlier, the tournament is going to be on March the 13th. That's on a Wednesday. The semis will be on the 14th, and the finals will be on the 15th. 15th is on a Friday, so Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday will be the NJCAA Region 2 tournament in Muskogee, Oklahoma. That is in between Oklahoma City and Tulsa. They will have a link that you'll be able to watch online. This channel will not be available, so you have to go online to watch it. Okay, let's see who's out there. Harley's still out there, and Williams. They're back on the court. Terrence Austin thought they were coming out, but they were due to the timeout. So basically, he wanted to give some love for Jackson Lawley. 1 minute left in this game, and there's Terrence Austin. Be sure to send your love to these players. Now he's going to send Jackson back in the game. Coach just want to make sure you get them all in. Giving his sophomores in some love on tonight. Now in the game, number zero, Jafet Tariq. He's a 6'3 freshman from Dallas, Texas. Misses the shot. Timeout, Murray, 56 seconds. Rustin Coffee in the game. Trayvon, Superman! Aggie fans showing their support. Emory Everhart. Okay, we're going to do it right this time. Stanley Harley. You have to know his story. He got hurt last year. He was on a roll. 86-58 Aggies. Jackson Lawley with a three-pointer. From the First United Spinlight logo. Oh, God. Got him for 12 points on tonight. Shot is up, and it's an air ball. Day Campbell. Lewis. Lawley. Oh, he felt it. That was from the logo, folks. Just feed it to him. 15 points tonight, five dimes. Another three-pointer on tonight. That was hit by 13, Churchill from Anadarko. 9 seconds, 92-61 is going to be our final on tonight. Want to say congratulations to the Murray State Aggies on a huge win on tonight. They did it, and they did it big on this evening. So congratulations to Murray State. We'll be right back, so keep it right here. We're going to come back here in a few minutes and hear from the coach, and we'll get ready for that. So stick around, folks, so we can get the comments from Coach Davis.
My name is LaFrieda Dunes, Realtor and CEO of the KLS Group, brokered by Ready Real Estate, located in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex, one of the fastest-growing areas in the U.S. As a full-service realtor, my clients include sellers, investors, new construction, and I specialize in helping first-time homebuyers and my fellow veterans. As a retired U.S. Army veteran, my focus continues to be service, dedication, and respect. I take pride in mentoring new agents within my brokerage and helping to create top producers in the real estate industry. If you are looking to buy in the DFW area, please call me for a free consultation at 817-975-9284. You can also visit my website at labritadues.com. That's www.labritadews.com.
All right, folks, welcome back to the Murray State Aggie YouTube channel. Coach Davis is with me. Coach, let's hear what you got to say.
Just not a better way to send out the sophomores. Really, really proud of our guys, really happy for them. Every one of our sophomores. So we had sophomore night before, and you saw every single family here for every single sophomore. And I mentioned that to the guys before, and I mentioned that to a couple of the families, how special that is. And it just, there's a reason these guys are such hard workers. They're so high character. They're so fun to be around. And they mesh so well together on and off the court. It's because they were brought up the right way. And they know that that's a blessing way bigger than however many points they scored or whatever they did tonight or any other night. They all won the lottery with their families. And so that just spoke volumes in itself. I didn't expect to, but like it actually kind of brought a tear to my eye before the game. Like these guys are special to me. So first group of guys, like a couple of them I only had for a year, but the year that I had with Emery and Trey, it's been a special year. Like they've both been through things. They've both grown. They've both developed both on and off the court so much. And, man, I just can't say enough positive things about these five sophomores that were honored here tonight. And so I love it. I love it.
Man, you know, I just want to commend you. I mean, you guys jumped out on them. Jackson Lawley hit the game. He was in the zone.
Yeah.
I counted him tonight for at least 5 3-pointers.
Nice.
He shot from the logo on one of them.
Well, you want that, because when you're a sophomore, when it's your last year, when you're going out, that's how you.
See his family over there hugging him right now?
Yeah.
Everybody, you know.
That's how you want him to play. So I was proud of him. I was happy for him. I was just, you know, he's that guy that just kind of, he's such a positive guy to be around, and he's not playing much and all that, and he always is just so positive and just so happy and so joyful. And so you can't thank players like that enough, because you would love for everyone to get 30 minutes a game, but the hometown hero and all that, like, you just want him when it is his moment to do that, and that was awesome.
My stats ain't unofficial, but I had 14 3-pointers tonight.
Yeah,
I was raining them.
Guys were, that was the big key of the game. Make plays for others, create shots for others. So I bet we had a lot of assists. We did that, and then obviously we hit them at a high clip. So,
man, I'm just honored to be able to. I was thinking about you earlier today. I started calling. I said, no, I'm gonna wait till the game's over. And I want to say thank you for accepting me when I first got here. Okay, here comes your baby. Now, what's her name again?
Audrey.
Hey, Audrey. Okay. She'll be out there. All the kids are out there now because everybody's looking at the camera. But, you know, this is year number two, and it's been a journey.
Yeah.
And it's getting better.
Yeah.
So how do you build it and go from here, Coach Davis?
Well, this was our first year. This will be our first year. Like, we had a couple key returners this year, but we still had to build that culture and the program into our guys this year. And so what you saw in January, the growth from that. And so we saw growth my first year, but it was just too slow, and it was just too little, too late type of deal. And this year we've kind of hit a different stride. We're now tied for third place in the region. The two top teams, you got to give them a ton of credit. They're really, really, really high level teams.
And that's Connors and NEO.
Yeah, and they're both top 25 level teams. Without a shadow of a doubt. So we're right on that edge. And so and like you saw, it's not like we can go in there in a tournament atmosphere, and we can go knock either one of them off. And these guys know that. So
if you're, let's say if you get three, who are you scheduled to go up against? Because
I think that's Tonkawa. If we're three, it's Tonkawa. We're gonna have a coin flip.
Really?
Because us and Western both have identical records. So it's gonna be a coin flip to see who's third and who's fourth, but we both tied for third. It's an identical tie. There's no easy tiebreaker between us, because we have, like I said, we split with each other, and we have identical records within the region. So,
was there any team that you beat twice during the season? Was it you split with Eastern?
We split with Eastern.
What about Redlands?
We beat Tonkawa twice. We beat Redlands twice, Enid twice, and Seminole twice.
Mm-hmm.
So we beat quite a few teams twice, but then we also got swept by NEO and Connors.
Yeah. Well, Wednesday is going to be game one in Muskogee.
Yeah.
Semifinals will be on.
Is it Wednesday or Thursday?
I got to double check. It's 13th, 14th, and 15th.
Okay.
So I told everybody that they need to go to the Murray State Ag website, and the way they do it is the Region 2 will have the TV crew there.
Yep.
And you'll be able to watch them. The announcers. I do plan on driving up there, so I'll be sitting in the stands. I'll be somewhere just waving. But as you look out there on the court and you see all these families here, you know, and you played in Shawnee. They have the Great American Conference going on this weekend.
Yeah.
There, and that's where schools like Southeastern and Southwestern all competing in there, and those schools from Arkansas. So, but it's so hard in JUCO to keep the guys, because you only get 2 years with them.
Right. That's the hard part, and that's the hard part as you start out, because you're starting out with young guys. So it's really important that you bring some guys back. And so this year we have one guy sitting out who will be really important, and then we have three to four well, 4 to 5 really, really important young men that'll have a chance. I think we'll have a chance to bring back next year, and that will next year. That will be a huge blessing. Obviously, I'm getting ahead of myself.
That's all right.
We got some games to play.
That's right. We're going to think positive, too. But I want to close out by, first of all, thinking of your athletic director here, Gary Bandy.
Coach Bandy's done a good job this year, and we're glad to have him.
The brothers, your assistant coaches?
The best coaches in the business.
Best
assistant coaching staff, along with my pops. Best assistant coaching staff in the nation, hands down.
And to the Aggie Nation.
Yep, we're super thankful for our fans. We're especially thankful when softball and baseball are here because they're rowdy and we love.
Oh yes, they're rowdy, boy. Normally the coaches got to sit up there with them with the baseball team because you'll hear guys up there at the free throw line shooting and all of a sudden this chicken sound go here, chick 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 chick. You know,
they're fun.
And also Emory and them left you something with a Hawaiian tradition. Explain that this type of layoff.
Well, they're just A1 people. Like, they love the team. They love what we're doing with them and all that, and they're so appreciative and thankful. So anytime they have a chance to bring a little Hawaii to Tishomingo, they try to do so just to inundate our guys and you know, kind of they're just kind of like, hey, everybody's kind of an extended part of our family. So it's awesome.
I thanked all the fans on tonight. Chris Austin says, great win. Thanks for a great season. We'll be an Aggie fan forever.
Awesome.
Harold Smith says, I missed some, but the Aggies pulled it off. Great game, sophomores. Your future is bright.
Yep.
Great team, great game, nephew. That's Trayvon's family right there. So,
nice.
And he says, and we ain't finished.
Nope, we're not done.
So we want to let you know, and I consider it an honor. I think the only other team I know that's in the region that has an announcing team is Eastern. I was checking them out, and they got a pretty good team over there in Wilburton. So we're glad to have this here because the families, they can, you know, watch online. The way the game has changed now, they can keep up with what's going on because it costs money to come down here. And the one thing about being in Oklahoma, you can go to Durant. You can go down to West Bay in Kingston. You got first-class hotels. I would encourage you to come down and bring your family to go fishing. And you're saying, well, Cedric, why are you saying that? Because tonight, when you called out the sophomores, you know what they said that their best moment was? I got to go fishing.
Yeah.
I got to do something I don't get a chance to do in the big city. And that was bond. And again, for those who don't know, what was that bonding like that you did at the beginning of the season? What was that again?
Well, we've done a few things, but the team bonding early in the season was we went to a lake. We did end up going to a lake house, and a very generous donor gave us kind of a couple nights stay at their place, and he let us ride their Sea-Doos, and he let us get on his boat and all that stuff. So the guys really enjoyed that. And again, like that's like you said, that was something they don't do often, so it's good to have those things. And then we got just people in the community that took them out fishing recently, you know, we have some videos that you need to see of Ignis not wanting to touch a fish.
Oh, really? Iggy didn't want the man from London?
Yeah, he's 6'8", and he's scared of catfish. So, no, it's just the guys have fun, and the guys have blended with the community amazing. As you see, like, all the people out here right now, besides families, they're all the community members that spend time out of their own lives with their own families and all that just to hang out with our guys. And our guys love it, and our guys are super thankful. So I'm super thankful of this whole situation, and it's we're getting a little bit too sentimental.
I'm gonna stop right there. I'm sorry, Coach.
But
it's my fault, y'all. I'm sorry, but I have to say that because here's what you're doing: you're saving a young man's life, somebody that's tried to find something, but they come here to Tishomingo and they find one thing. You know what that is? I care, and that's what it is. You know, when you come back here in May when it's graduation time, you'll say, "Wow, I remember when that person thought about throwing in the towel, but we had a long talk, and then they reestablished themselves." That's what it's all about. And then your retention rate, keeping them here, because I remember when I came here, I said, this dude got a problem. he got 15 guys he got to try to figure out how to get them time in, and you're working with nine. So you got other guys like that's here, Quincy Jones, Mason Hill, Seth Wilkins.
So Seth's out, but he was here tonight. Isaac's out, but he's here tonight. Quincy and Brevin both came to support. Like, everyone was here, pretty much. So, and Isaac will be back next year. So it's guys are, this is definitely a tight-knit group.
Well, listen, I'm not going to get in trouble. Gary Bandy's already pointed.
All right.
One time,
go.
And I don't want to make him
back.
We got
to go coin flip.
All right, coin flip. All right. We'll look forward to it. God bless you. Thank you so much, Coach Davis.
Thank you, sir.
And thank you to all the Aggie fans on being here on tonight. We had a wonderful time. Congratulations. Murray State wins the game. Final score was 92-61. We thank you so much for following us. You guys have a great evening and continue to watch the video. And thank you, Murray State, for allowing me, Dr. Tim Fulton, everybody for allowing me to be the voice of the Murray State Aggies. It's been an honor. Be sure to go to bgcsports.net. You'll see the pictures I posted of the sophomores, and you'll be able to see them there. Murray State's going to have them posted, too, as well. It's all about the community here in southern Oklahoma. This is Chickasaw Nation, and this is the original home for the Chickasaw Nation, which is Tishomingo, Oklahoma. You got to definitely come check it out. We're out of here. Have a great day.